Welcome to Elite at level Prey on the Hunter in Reaver's Refuge. Actually, 100 level. Now, this isn't Ginger Spice, my main druid. This is a secondary druid, Azalea. And she was just my stand-in druid while I was working on Ginger Spice's past lives. And don't really play this tune much anymore. But I wanted to do some videos, some heroic level content, upper heroic level content, just to demonstrate the build. And that it can solo, you know, elite heroics with no problem. Right up through 20. And this is a good quest to do because it can be kind of confusing to people who are newer to it. This quest map is like a big maze. Here we're just waiting for the ice to break out. I did another video earlier and it was a little bit a little jumpy. I think that the video program doesn't really like Body of the Sun. So far, just one way to go here. Everything just respawns in this map, so there's no point in hanging back to fight everything unless the dungeon alert gets out of hand. Here we're just going to wait for this wall to break out. And at this intersection we want to go left. We're going to wait for the wall to break out again. If we had gone straight, it would just loop right back around. Here and wait for the floor to break out. Now here's a part where if you're doing it with a group, usually you're going to split up. Some people are going to go left and some people are going to go right at this intersection. And you're looking for a lever, a big lever, that is going to bring down this blue barrier here. You can't get past it until the lever's pulled. I just wait till the walls break. We're going to go left first. And it's in a random location, but there's certain spots that it will spawn. There's just one lever, and you can actually backspace around or queue around whatever it is you use to select non-combat target. Non-combat objects. And the first place that the lever could be is actually right here at this intersection on top of that little hill, but it's not there, so we'll go left. And this wall you can actually break just by hitting it. Sometimes you can pick up the lever right through walls. This tune is actually not humans, PDK. Another wall you can break out on your own. And the lever might have been up here, but it's not. So we're going to turn right back around. Somebody's recently asking me about my gear set for my teen levels, and right now using the frozen tunic, braces of wind, and cloak of flames from the house sea challenges, vile blasphemy, heroic normal wall of wood, green steel lit 2 scimitar, green steel concordant opposition item, 150 spell points, green steel mineral 2 hit point item. So you can just keep queuing around or backspacing around whatever key you use. Dungeon alert's getting green. Little dead end cavern here, it's not up there. So we're gonna go to the west, and this will actually just loop right back around and meet up with the passageway, which was to the right at the intersection where that blue barrier was. We went to the left, and here's the lever. But I'm just gonna keep going this way just to show you that it does meet up back at that intersection. Not gonna backtrack. There also can be a chest hidden throughout the map. It just has trash loot. But you can look around for it as you're moving through these passages. So Dungeon Alert just got to yellow. So it might have to take a minute to kill some of this trash. And if you're not familiar with this this quest line, here's that barrier where we came. We went left, which is that way, and we just came from the right because we looped around. If you're not familiar with this quest line in Reaver's Refuge, and this would be, you know, this one, Prey on the Hunter, End of the Kobold, and Monastery of the Scorpion, these are the quests that are going to flag you for Stealer of Souls, which is going to let you get your dragon-touched armor, which isn't so exciting anymore, but it used to be endgame armor back when the level cap was 20. Well, if you look up here, by the way, if you've never noticed, you can actually see the dragon up there. And that's Osirikax. That's the same dragon that you met in Misery's Peak in Korthos. And we'll be seeing the dragon again at the end. But, Dragon Touch Armor, actually, it's a minimum level 16 armor. You can make outfits and robes all the way up to heavy armor. It's got three tiers, very customizable. You can still make some pretty nice armor for your upper teen levels. Earthquake works outstanding on these giants. Body of the Sun, an awesome spell. It is cheap to cast, doesn't maximize or empower, so you're saving spell points there, but it tiers better than Firewall. So the damage that it does actually keeps up with Firewall pretty well. And so it's cheaper to cast, moves with you, and it's a buff so it can be extended. So actually in my build post, I think at level 18, I say that I dump extend, but I actually like to use it right up through like level 19 and 20 because I'm still using Body of the Sun a lot. But really, it's about the only reason to keep extend at this point is for Body of the Sun, because your buffs are already lasting, you know, 18 minutes on extended. So we're just gonna kill this red name using Word of Balance, Firewall, Storm of Vengeance, Produce Flame, Call Lightning. So right now I'm just using unmaximized, unempowered Produce Flame, just 6 spell points, and still doing a few hundred damage to him on a non-crit. High 200s, almost 600 on a crit. Let's see what other gear I didn't go over. Torque. Vibrant Purple Iron Stone upgraded really nice. Archmagi, spell penetration 3 at level 5. Great for any spellcaster. Just a crafted evocation 2, greater false life ring. Crafted fire absorption 33%, feather falling boots. Crafted health 6, melee alacrity 10%. With a large guild slot, I got 20 extra hit points there. And goggles with resistance 4. For alacrity. Here, if you hang out under this stalactite, it'll drop you right onto the chest below. And there it is. It's just a junk chest, though. Just grab it and go. To an intersection up here, there's gonna be four giants, and you gotta kill the cleric for the wall beyond them to break away. Then you can just run by them. You may have to fight them all anyways, because there is a shrine beyond them that you're gonna want to use, and they can follow you up there. But we'll just see if we get away just doing the cleric. After the cleric died. If you ever need to lose Body of the Sun fast for some reason, you got mobs you don't want to damage, just switch forms. You can only use it in fire elemental form, so as soon as you switch to a different form, it goes away. Shrine real quick. You can rest on the other side of the shrine that way in case the giants follow you up here, you know, and they start ranging you. At least this will give you a couple extra seconds before they catch up to you and the melee starts swinging at you. So we got lucky this time, they didn't follow us up. Now up ahead here's another confusing part for people who are newer to this quest. There's a maze, and this maze is broken into two parts, and both parts have a left, right, and middle selection, a way that you could go. So when you first come to the maze here, you want to check to the right first, because if it's not to the right, it's just going to be a dead end right away, like this. It's actually very rarely right there. Check middle, and you can see it's a dead end here. And this is the left, this other direction over here, this is nothing. Just a room. So this is the left direction here. And you'll know you went the right way because you'll see dragon eggs behind a barrier in the ceiling right there. So once you get to this barrier, you know that you're to the second part of the maze. And so now it's going to be left, middle, or right again. When you get to the second part, always check middle first, because you can see right away that it's a dead end if it's not the right way to go. And then you want to check left next, because it would be a dead end before too long, like you're seeing here. Oh, actually, yeah. So it's a dead end, and then you want to do right last, because right can actually go on a long ways before it's a dead end. And you don't want to take that extra time, because you got to get through this maze as fast as possible. And the reason is that Osirikaex, the white dragon, is in the end fight and is already getting beaten on by the giants at the end fight. And if the giants beat her down before you kill the red name giant, you lose. You'll fail the quest. So there's going to be some melee giants, there's going to be some mages and some clerics. Clerics are going to be top priority because they are going to cast Blade Barrier, which can tear up the dragon if the dragon's running through it. But once the red name giant spawns the boss, you want to take him down as fast as possible. And you're going to use, you can use Earthquake and Sunburst as crowd control. Sunburst will blind them, and Earthquake will knock them down really easily. So you come to this big room here, and Dragon's going to be right up here to the left. As you can see, getting beaten on. You want to keep an eye on the Dragon's health, already down to below 75% right now. Throw some Earthquakes down. You want to kill some of this trash before the red name will spawn. College Yarn. We take out the clerics first. You want to watch the AoEs here because the dragon can be damaged. The dragon is not fighting for you at this point. You don't want to do more damage to the dragon. Boss will spawn from that cavern down there. The DM will announce it. Might have to drink a pot or two. Health down to about 2/3. might be specific giants that you gotta kill to make the boss spawn not positive. He does seem to be taking a little while to spawn. Dragon's still a little bit above 50. You really just want to focus on the boss at this point. Call lightning, produce flame, word of balance. Up to take care of the giants. Not good when the dragon aggro's on you. Call lightning and word of balance will hit whatever target that you designate, but produce flame can hit something if it jumps in between. So you want to be careful that the dragon's not between you and Kalajarn, or whatever giants you're targeting. Check the dragon's health. Still at about 50, so we're doing just fine. Once Kalajarn is dead, the dragon can no longer be damaged by your own by your spells. The dragon will be fighting with you. I'll have to drink a couple little pots here. Little daily roll pots. healed by the clerics. Yeah, I'm just gonna have to bite the bullet and drink a bigger pot. There we go. So now the dragon can't be damaged by your AoEs anymore. So you go ahead and throw Firewall, Body of the Sun. And once the giants are dead, you're going to talk to the dragon, and you're going to want to make sure that you tell the dragon, yes, we have a deal. If you choose the other dialogue options, then you're going to end up fighting the dragon. And she'll call forth her mate as well, so you're going to be fighting two white dragons, which at this point, usually pretty low in resources. And the extra treasure chest that you get for fighting them both, not really worth it. You can get a white dragon scale, but you know, if you want to get white dragon scales, go farm Tor. And you tell her, yes, we have a deal. Take her treasure over here. This, these treasure chests behind the barrier would be the ones you would get if you fought her and her mate, which we're not doing. Hey, thanks for watching. Gonna be doing some other videos. Gonna be doing Enter the Kobold at level on Elite soon. That'll probably be the next one. And then gonna do some instructional videos out in Amarath, how to do Genesis Point solo. If you have any questions about the build, feel free to send me a tell if you're on Sarlona, or you can respond to my forum posts. Thanks again for watching.